Good evening once again. This is the second part of the tutorial on AutoCAD Basics. Stan will continue on from the introduction and drawing basic shapes. I'm going to modify them. So basically, we did some lines this time. We didn't do the circle, so as part of this tutorial, we will go through the circle. Copy, move, erase, trim, we used last time. I'm going to introduce rotate. With this, and then we did offset a bit, and then have to use the command group or regions. So I'll go through and then to show you. So in the previous tutorial, tutorial 1, we did a window with 1,200 millimeters, window frame that is, and then for this one, it's the door. So it's 890 by 890, and then we've got this quadrant or quad connected to it. So we get straight into the door tutorial. So this part of my AutoCAD, that's the file from the previous tutorial. So we'll start basically out here. So I'll start with the line function view. I'll just go click line. I said my line was 890, so I'm just keeping it like I did before. Bring it down, 890. Enter. I go across. 890. Enter. Press the escape button to complete the function. It's now got that quadrant, the two lines. Now I want to build a quadrant cycle. So I'll just click on the circle, just click on that, then I just basically decide to try to create that quadrant, but it's obviously doesn't. So I'll just try it in the center, try again, click on the solid, and now I've got it. It's come where it says snap to end frame, and I've got this big circle, I want a quadrant. So I have to trim out the parts that I don't need, which is the big one here. I'm going to use the trim function, which is here. I'll just click on trim, and it asks me to select objects at the bottom. So I just select the line to trim again. So I just keep these two lines, this one and this one. That means that whatever that's outside of it will be cut out. So I click the enter button. Select the axis, and then now it says select object to trim. So I just click trim, and then it's gone. And I give it the shape. Done that, so that's it. So I've got this. Now you've got three separate pieces. Okay, I just it's a good practice each time you do something, just to save. I'm just saving. I renamed it as to already. Okay, now I've got this door. But you see, I want to move it as a big unit. That's when I use the function. I can say a group. So I just type group. But yeah, I can use group. If it's a group, I'm close solid. It as a unit. That's the door you have got. It's the window basically appended. Say I want to rotate, so I'll use the rotate function. It's in the wrong way, so I'll just keep. I can type arrow or click this rotate button. So I'll just click on it. Then it asks for a base point. So I'll just put a base point here and then I'll just click on that. Basically rotates around it, can be that, or you can rotate it, you just move the mouse on it's all possible with that. Yeah, so that's rotate. So I'll put it at this angle, and then it's got this. Yeah, so basically that's there. We've got our windows. I have to also return this to add this to return. So I can move it anywhere I want. It's a unit. So it's here. I'm supposed to go here. I've got my window in, and I've got my door. So I'll just delete all this. Just select by using the mouse, and then you can press the delete button, or you can press the erase button. Basically, save that again. Save, and then that's a quick thing. So that's that. Basically, in the next tutorial, I'll just show you how to put the layout of the drawing, which is this one here. Well, just because of the size limitation, upload and download, and just having it as small segment so you can see the upload and download in place. So for tutorial 2, that will be it. Thank you very much.